Thank you for joining us here on the Auburn Medical Group YouTube channel discussing this video on an abscess drainage that Dr. Gawayne Vaughan did.
Yep.
Dr. Gawayne, thank you for joining us on the YouTube channel.
It's my pleasure.
Yeah. This case, if I remember correctly, the patient had diabetes and had been seen the week before, is that right?
Came back and she had this large area over the left ankle that was just very red and inflamed. It was warm to touch. And there was that area over the lateral, the outside of the ankle, that was, maybe 4 or 5 centimeters in diameter, that was just really bulging and swollen. And when you pushed on it, it was what we call fluctuant, just kind of boggy, which indicates that there was some fluid underneath it.
So with fluid being underneath it, that would be an abscess. In watching this video, if you're squeamish or you don't like seeing fluid come out of people's bodies, do not proceed and watch the rest of this video.
Well, I can tell you now that we made the right decision to cut it.
Oh, good.
Lots of pus in there.
Okay. Well, you can feel that. I had no doubt.
That? Yeah, that there was a collection in there.
Yeah.
Yep. There it comes. I have a feeling we're going to have to pack this too.
Okay.
So, but we'll get all the pus out first.
Okay. Now, when you drained it, you also were poking it with a probe. What was that all about?
There can be what we call loculations, or areas where there's septations and the pus can get loculated or caught.
So you packed in some gauze wick.
I did. And the biggest reason we do that is to keep it open. It's going to continue to drain, and we want it to continue to drain as long as there's pus collecting in the area. So the biggest reason is not for that to make the infection go away, but to keep it open to keep that pus draining out.
And our viewers may see other similar videos where a culture is taken. You did not take a culture in this particular case.
I didn't. She's a diabetic, so there is a slight increase possibility that this may be a weird infection. The biggest thing we worry about is an anaerobic infection. But anaerobic infections have a very distinct smell. You don't have smell-o-vision, so I guess we weren't able to.
You don't know.
But actually, it didn't have that distinct smell, so I did not take a culture. The most likely one here, given the abscess, is MRSA, a staph infection, resistant staph.
Okay, and you can watch a video on that here.
So here we are 2 days later to re-examine the wound. As you can see, the redness has gone down a bit. The area has been covered in dressing this whole time, so we'll take that off and take a look at the abscess. The area where the abscess is a little macerated, meaning it is a little wet and moist in the area. This means that it has continued to drain while we had that dressing on it. It does also mean that we need to repack it at this time.
Well, thank you for joining us, Dr. Gawayne Vaughan.
My pleasure.
Until next time, this is Dr. Gawayne Vaughan and Dr. Mark Vaughan telling you to stay in good health. A reminder, we are doctors, but we're not your doctor, unless we are your doctor. But if that's the case, we need to take care of any similar thing here in person in our office. This video is not diagnosing you or treating you or allowing you to treat anyone else. This is just for educational purposes only, not for medical treatment.